So this topic of bar of uniform strength is about finding about the area of cross-section variation for a bar so that it has a constant uniform stress throughout the bar when the weight of the bar is also taken into account. Up to now, what we have studied is that if this is a bar of self weight W, so small W is weight per unit volume. So that means if I consider an element on the extreme lower part, so there will be no stress on it. As I move up, the section will experience the weight of the lower portion. So there will be some stress in this. And as I move further up, the stress developed here, let it be sigma 2 and it is sigma 1. So obviously sigma 2 will be less than sigma 1 because the portion of the bar below the section 2 is higher than the portion of bar below section 1. So you can see that the stress is varying within the bar. But we want to design a bar that is having constant stress throughout its length. So for that, it is very obvious that we have to vary the cross-section area because we know that stress is equal to force by area. Resistive force varies with the position of the cross-section, but at present A is constant. So if we simultaneously vary area also, so that can make the sigma constant. So let's start the analysis. So consider a bar that is fixed from lower end, and we know that it must be having some varying cross section. So an external force P is acting on it. And again, small w is weight per unit volume of the bar. Now consider a section at distance x from the top and the thickness of section is dx. Let's assume that A is the area at distance x. If I draw the free body diagram of this element, small element, so on the top, I will be having the stress of value sigma, and on the bottom, again, as per our requirement, the stress should be sigma. However, it is having some weight. So due to that weight, it will having a downward force of the magnitude small w, that is weight per unit volume into volume of this element. So now area on the top is A, area on the bottom is A plus delta A. So if I balance all the forces acting on this element, I will get an equation. So upward force that is acting on it is sigma, that is force stress into area, A plus delta A. that will be equal to the downward force acting on it, that is equal to sigma into area plus weight of it, that is force due to weight of it, that is small w a into dx. So if I simplify the equation, I get sigma into delta a is equal to w a dx. So further simplification will give me so integrating both sides, I will get log base e of a is equal to small w by sigma x plus constant. To find out this constant, we have to take the boundary condition into consideration, that is at top, that is when x is equal to 0, area of cross section is a naught. So when I put it in equation 1, I will get log base e a naught is equal to constant. So my equation becomes, equation 1 becomes so when I simplify it, I will get an expression that is log base e a by a naught is equal to w sigma by x. So this will give me that a is equal to a naught times e raised to power w x by sigma. So this is an expression that represents the variation of area. So that means this area should vary exponentially so that my stress will remain constant throughout this bar. So at any point, at any section, its stress will be sigma.